colleague interview was conducted with Betty Nelson for the Purdue University Oral History Program. It took place on Wednesday, March 14, 2007 at Stewart Center. The interviewer is Katherine Markee, the Oral History Library. Welcome. Tell us a little bit about where you were born and parents and siblings.
Your early life.
Well, born in Bluefield, West Virginia, which is the southernmost part of the state and in the middle of the Appalachian Mountains. Coal mining area, and one older brother, 10 years older than I, who was away most of the time I was growing up. He was off in the Second World War and then off to college. So, in some respects, it was second child and an only child.
after he did his graduate, he was going to come to Purdue, and that's how you happened to come. Tell us how you happened to come to Purdue with him. And
well, I finished my degree at Ohio University, and Dick had everything on his PhD completed except for the research, and he needed to be in a large urban area in order to have a population large enough, and the Baltimore public schools the Baltimore County schools were willing for him to do his research there and to use the computer equipment, the old UNIVAC system,
right,
the IBM cards, the whole bit. So that was why we chose Baltimore.
being a position that was primarily working with junior and Hell, which I didn't think I would find very stimulating, had shifted responsibility, so she offered me the opportunity to interview for a counseling position, and that sounded much more interesting to me. And after being chastised for having not responded to the first call, I thought I better set up an interview and go talk. So that was my initial challenging architecturally and programmatically for people with disabilities that students just didn't come. I think this was sort of the third leg on the civil rights stool. We've been through the minority, the ethnic groups, African Americans, establishing their right to access, then Right. And you can mark a zillion places in the Grant Street parking garage, but to get from there to Lowe, some folks just don't have the energy to do that.
And it isn't necessarily the physical handicap, it's the aging too. It's just very difficult. There's very slow walking.
Yes. So all of that was going on at that time, and our students were enormously helpful as consultants, and as we would try to make some adaptations in buildings and in the facilities, we had a group of students we could call on to come and react to it and make suggestions, and we certainly found that the more we could get students in contact with university personnel, whether it was folks in facilities planning or the plumbers or whoever, the more we could get those people who needed the
then it was